You listen to the SWN podcast.
And this is SWN.
Welcome to SWN.
Skull! Skull! Skull!
This is SWN.
And this is the Scottish Wrestling Network.
Where Scottish wrestling lives, I guess. Is that a tagline? I guess. I don't know.
Hello and welcome to the 300th edition of the SWN podcast. I'm your host, as always, Billy. We're back on the road. I've got my co-host next to me, driving me, because I am Miss Daisy. Say hello, Kelly.
Hello, Kelly.
I'm very excited because this is somebody's first ever WrestleZone show. You can't see him because he's directly behind me, asleep.
He's asleep.
But yes, this is Jack's first ever wrestling show. This is my 100th wrestling show. I did not do your stats to find it, unfortunately.
I don't really care.
But what if it was like your 15th or something? You know, just like a nice five number.
Yeah,
that would have been cool.
That would be nice.
I might find out before we put the episode out.
You publish.
Yes, but we're going to WrestleZone. We're going to Deanston Community Centre for Battle of the Nations. This is the first show since Aberdeen Anarchy. This is your first show since Regal Rumble.
Since the Rumble, yeah.
A lot has happened. I'll try to fill you in on as much as we can. We are taking the scenic route to Aberdeen because there's key shows on, so the roads are hoaching and the general direction. Which is better than the last time I did this road, because it's the road I was supposed to take to Pierhead, but I ended up in Keith because I'm an idiot, clearly. So
your directions are shocking.
Oh, I have no sense of direction.
Yeah.
I find places and
accidentally.
Well, that I've done that a lot of times. I did that for Ellen. I need to turn the car, find a place to turn, and I was at the Victoria Hall. I was like, oh,
yep.
Oh, cool.
I did that
for Inverurie as well. for finding the hopeful. So yeah, we're on the road. We're just in Banff at the moment. That's why we're a bit shaky, because the roads here are still stop start, and I'm holding the phone with my dodgy arm. Anyway,
that's clever.
Yeah, that's how I roll. If I'm driving home though, I could use my fancy phone holder though. So
we could have put it in there.
I could have done. But
I could have been the centre of attention.
You could have hosted.
Okay.
So there's seven matches as always, six on the main show, one on the pre-show. We of course have got VIP tickets because we're very important people, and I paid the £3 extra on the tickets.
Well,
so that's,
you know,
generally how it works.
That is exactly how it works.
VIP, how it works. I'm excited for this. We're apprehensive, a little bit scared.
Not sure how he's going to like it.
Not sure how he's going to like it. I mean, I think he's going to be fine, but it's bedtime's when the show starts.
Yeah.
So
that's the only thing that's kind of worrying me.
So we've got that.
That's whether he's going to cope with it. But he's having a nap right now.
He's having a nap.
He's already had one, so that's good innings.
We've got a music festival possibly tomorrow if the rain holds off.
It's McMurray and Elgin today and tomorrow.
So we have a packed weekend, and this
really
is.
Do.
This is.
It's almost too busy. I don't know if I like it.
I know. We're going to sleep well on.
Never.
Never. We never sleep well. But anyway, we're going to Deanston Community Centre, Battle of the Nations. Excited. My brief attempts to get Battle Bowl of the Nations has fallen on deaf ears. I've told you about Battle Bowl of the Nations before, haven't I?
I'm pretty sure you have.
I have, but I'll recap it for everyone.
Right.
Battle Bowl of the Nations. We haven't had a Battle of the Nations match in like 5 years, which used to be England versus Scotland. Right?
Okay.
There's been a flag match, but we haven't had Scotland versus England match in ages. So my suggestion was Battle Bowl of the Nations. And Battle Bowl was a concept by WCW where they had a bowl and the wrestlers all put their names in.
Oh, like swingers.
Not like swingers. They put their names in a.
How is it not like swingers?
To be honest, it's not going to get.
It's exactly like swingers.
My explanation is not going to get any better than to dissuade you that from this, that thought.
If they put their names in a bowl and then they just pick who they fight, that's exactly like swingers.
It gets worse.
The only difference is it's not keys.
It gets worse. So Battle Bowl of Nations was a tag team tournament. So there's four of them. The teams were assigned at random through the Battle Bowl,
and then
the winners would probably get like I think WCW did it weird. Like, the winners would then face each other, and then they would get a world title shot or something like that. But generally, my idea was that Battle Bowl of the Nations, winners get to face tag team champions. You know?
Yeah.
Get a random team, get some cool teams.
We're in Banff. We could go and get Murray Cup.
Oh, good.
sorry. This is totally not relevant.
Podcast cancelled. There's the one roundabout that I had to do for a driving
test.
It's not
a roundabout.
Well, I mean, if people...
It's a bone of contention. It is not a roundabout. It is a glorified corner.
Well, I passed my driving test here, so that says it all.
That tells me a lot.
Says it all.
That's why I always do the driving, people. Anyway.
It's for safety, because I think the last few times I've been driving myself to shows, I've gotten lost.
Exactly.
And I've went to these shows for 10 years, and I'm still getting lost going to these things.
But to be fair, it used to be at the Northern Hotel.
Oh, yeah. It's very difficult
to get lost.
Somewhere
that was quite easy to find, but...
There's another roundabout.
That's the other. It's still not a roundabout.
Where was it? Should we go back? Yeah, we'll go back to the wrestling chat.
Yes.
So yeah, so this is your first one since the Regal Rumble. So you saw some of the kickoff for the stories going into battle, going into Aberdeen Anarchy.
Yes.
And then here
and
we are at Nations.
My main man Caleb won the Rumble. So
Caleb won the Rumble. Yes, he did. I was very happy for him. I was a bit disappointed when Ronan went out, but I got over it eventually. He's still my pick to win next year.
Why haven't you learned yet? Anyone that you want to win is not going to win.
Yeah, it's really, that's kind of been the theme. There was a good period, a good long period of maybe a year of shows where every time I went, Aspen lost.
Yep.
And then when I wasn't there, he won.
Yep.
So there's something weird about that. Battle Nations, six matches on the main show, one on the pre-show. We'll go through them. We've got the pre-show match. So at the moment, WrestleZone Tri-Counties Championship Tournament is what's kicked off. Because Caleb won at Aberdeen Anarchy, became the undisputed and Tri-Counties champion.
Uh-huh.
So he has vacated his Tri-Counties title and has been put into a tournament, an 8-man tournament. Quarterfinals are tonight. Semi-finals, I'm guessing, will be hijinks, and then the winner will be probably Christmas Chaos.
Okay.
I think I can't see them doing matches at Stonehaven or Grenadine for it.
Okay.
So the VIP portion will have one of these matches, which will be Judas Grey versus Tommy Raiden.
Okay.
So this has been a little bit of story since Christmas Chaos, because Judas made his debut against Mickey Vago.
Yes.
And then Tommy, he goaded Tommy. Tommy hit Judas, which led to Mickey Vago win.
Yes.
And then they have the match at Aberdeen Anarchy, the six man, where Raiden, Vago, and Gangrel beat the Wallies and Judas. So there's a lot of backstory. This is one that's got quite a bit of backstory towards it.
Okay.
I'm a little bit apprehensive because I have no problems using Jack as a shield.
Please do not use our child as a shield.
I'm looking forward to this one. I like Judas.
Judas. I think he's really, his presence in the ring is just, he's got a bright future.
He's everywhere. Him and Ronan are like...
And so they should be. Out of the people that we've seen a lot more recently, that's our car beeping, just ignore it. I think that he and Ronan, Judas and Ronan, have got really good, they've got a lot of potential to go really far in this business. And I just hope that it doesn't go to their heads.
Yeah.
But, you know, if they have a good head on their shoulders, which I feel like they both do, they're going to go far.
But yeah, they've been...
Then if they do, we can say that we knew them when.
But they've been... Check their Instagram. They're in Wales doing training. They're at Pursuit in England doing training. They're in Ireland. They're just Europe.
That's good. It's dedication.
And they've got a quite good network of trainers. They've got Aspen and Emerson Jane and stuff like that. They've got a good crowd of people that'll direct them into places to go.
Look at Joe Hendry. You know.
Exactly. Yeah, I think Judas started through Joe Hendry's school, and I think that's where his main kind of place is, the
Disco
Academy, where that's where Aspen and Emerson.
You might want to hold that in your good hand, because this is a windy road.
I know, I've just switched hands for the exact reason, because I knew we were into a windy path. So yeah, I'm looking forward to that. I mean, it would be good to see Tommy win, go forward, because he's still very, very fresh and got this thing, but I think Judas has got it.
I think Judas has got that, to be honest. He's just got an edge over Tommy that I think would win him the match. Mm-hmm. I mean, I think Tommy will put up a good fight, mm-hmm. but yeah, I think, personally, I think that's a Judas match.
And it's a case of, because Vago's in the main event against Caleb, will Vago come out to support Tommy, or will he concentrate on his match that he's got later on? So will Tommy have to do it on his own, or will he have backup?
I think Tommy's a big enough boy now that he can fight someone by himself.
Yeah.
And I think they should allow him to do that.
Oh yeah.
But you know, if Vago comes out and assists, then who's going to come out and assist Judas?
Judas has got Odin. He's got a title match as well, so I'm interested, I'm waiting to see if I was
in their shoes, I don't think I'd be putting my attempt at a title match on the line just to come out and sort out something else that's not a title match, you know. It's still an important match, but it's not as important as a title, so you know, I think I'd rather fight my own battle.
Yeah. So yeah, I think it's going to be that's a hell of a VIP match as well to put on for £3 extra or something. You get to go and see, like you're saying, Judas especially is going to be a guy that we're going to see a lot more of in other places as well. So he's getting while you can.
Absolutely.
Get to see him, and then you can do like what I do when I'm watching Clash of the Castle or something. I'm seeing Alba Fire and I'm sitting there going, I saw Kayleigh do wrestle in Aberdeen back in 2013.
Some of these people you've seen properly through the ranks are finally making their way, and
get on the indies while you can, get on there while you can see these people, and then
you can say that you saw them when, you know, you saw them before they were on these big productions, you know.
I mean, I spoke to Jack Morris very recently on the podcast, and he's doing mega things.
He's doing the stuff in Japan.
Yeah, he's doing the mega stuff in Japan, and I saw him wrestle a bucket.
That's quite a contrast.
That is quite a contrast. So to see him wrestle a bucket at the Fisherman's Hall, and now he's the big Tokyo Domes.
That's where my granny and granddad met.
Now he's wrestling at Korakuen Hall and Tokyo Dome and these big arenas in Japan. Getting well spent. Main card then, so we'll continue the tournament stuff. We'll just finish off the tournament matches while our car beeps at us for just slightly going over our line.
Yeah.
It's been a bone of contention in previous road trip episodes.
Yes, it has.
Okay, I'm furious with it. So we've got Evan, so we've got the Wallies against Greenan and Young. So they're kind of split off into two matches. So at Aberdeen Anarchy, Chris Archer defeated Evan Young.
Uh-huh.
And in that process, it meant that Evan Young and Oliver Green are now under the charge of Chris Archer for the next year.
Okay.
So he's essentially mentoring them against their will.
Okay.
And Archer will not be there this weekend. He's announced in a promo. He will not be there. He's leaving Young and Green to it. But not to be complacent and do all his teachings, etc., etc. And Young, Green seems to be kind of accepting this, but Evan Young is not. So the first one we'll go with Evan Young versus Brian Tucker, a match that I've seen before. I thought you had, but you were in Aberdeen Anarchy 22, but Johnny Lyons came back for a night.
Oh, cool.
Young defeated Brian Tucker on that night, so it's kind of a rematch from 2 years ago. Apologise for everyone watching the video, I didn't take my sunglasses with me, so I'm just squinting. That may be a bit better. So we've got Tucker versus Young, both coming off losses at Aberdeen Anarchy. Tucker only needs to win the Tri-County Championship to become the only second ever Triple Crown / Grand Slam winner in WrestleZone.
Well, he can't do that before Caleb.
Caleb just needs to win the tag titles, so that's just a skull, but all over it.
But they're not speaking right now in WrestleZone, are they?
Seems to be a bit of tension on that front. So Young versus Tucker. I don't know how to really. I think it'll be because Tucker always puts on a good match, entertaining match.
He's an entertainer.
Entertainer, absolutely. Young's got this kind of piss and vinegar fire about him. It's just like, you know what? He'll like this comparison. I feel like if he grew a bit of mutton chops, he'd be like a right cracking Wolverine. You know, just because he's just like
a baby Wolverine.
It's just like comic accurate Wolverine, who's like 5'3". He's like,
oh, okay.
You know, not the one in Deadpool Wolverine. Which was like CGI'd down Hugh Jackman.
Where are you going?
Oh, it's going to die.
Oh, Jesus wank. Christ.
Sorry.
Sorry.
Some fanny has decided to overtake
over.
Everything.
What a shock.
Wankers. So we've got that. This should be fine. I don't know who's going to win that because that could be either or. I could really go either way. For that, and then same with Oliver Green and Rhys Dawkins. I really like what Rhys is putting out at the moment. And again,
so they, have the Wallies kind of?
No, Wallies are still.
Wallies are still together.
They're still together.
Still tagging along.
Still tagging along. So Green didn't have a match at Abernathy. He came out with Evan Young because he broke his nose down in Wales, I think it was, doing training. So these guys, none of these guys. Yeah, none of these guys are coming in with particularly good momentum because the Wallies lost in that six man with Gangrel and Speed Metal and Judas. So they all need a win. And I think, right, so the whole thing was Tucker came up to Rhys in promo and said, we'll both go through and we'll meet in the final, better man win. And then the match brackets came out and they're both on the same side. So the earliest, the latest they'll meet will be the next round. If they both win, so I don't know. I think Rhys could probably go through. I haven't seen Rhys win.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's one of those matches. One of those.
I don't really feel like I have an opinion on that one.
Yeah, just they're gonna happen. I think if Archer was there, maybe a bit more intrigue, because he would have had to be shouting orders, barking orders, maybe a little bit more. Oh. But otherwise, yeah, they'll be good matches. And the last. Of the tournament matches, we have Alex Webb, who's on his own because he had Air Miles' final match at Abernathy. And he's taken on Captain Alan Sterling.
Toot toot.
So Captain Alan taking on Alex Webb. Captain Alan, a former Tri-Counties champion, he said in a video that he's going to bring all of his semen to defeat Alex Webb. So, thoughts? That statement is just, we'll just leave that one hanging in the air.
Yeah, I'm sorry, I'm trying not to laugh.
He also said he's not afraid of spiders.
He doesn't know what he's doing.
He also said he's not afraid of spiders.
He's not afraid of spiders.
Not afraid of spiders.
That's good.
So Alex Webb, he won. Captain Allen thinks he won at Abernathy because he got his hat back. But that was because Omar didn't take his hat back after winning his Shirvani in the ladder match. And Captain Allen picked it up off the floor and celebrated. What'd you say? No. Repeat it for the class.
I can't. It's fine.
I'll go back and review the footage. Don't worry. Again, Alex has got a little bit, he's now a singles star in WrestleZone, primarily been tag team with Miles. He needs this. Captain Allen's just one of those guys you can have on a show and he's just going to be purely entertaining, belt or no belt. So I'd like to see Alex move on. And that creates potentially Alex Webb versus Judas Gray, which I think would be
absolutely cracking. Match.
Yeah. Which unfortunately will probably be a Halloween hijinks and we won't be there. So, That would be good. That'd be good. And then their side of things. I would say Rhys. Why not? Give us Rhys and Tucker. That would just be an absolute riot of a match. Them trying to work it out.
Fight each other.
Tucker thinking it's a tag team match or something like that. And
yeah. That can only go one way, can't it?
Which is a shame for Green and Young. But I think I'd like to see Green and Young maybe mix it up with Ronan and Connor maybe. Tag team. That'd be good. Speaking of them. Tag team title match. We've got Ronan King and Connor Malloy, Flippy and Drippy, defending against the Outfit, which at the moment it looks like it's Ted and Murphy.
All right.
In the video, they put up a wee promo
Yeah.
Where it looked like Ted's got this crisis of confidence thing going because he was the one who got pinned and he's still got a bit of a damaged shoulder at the moment. So my conspiracy will always be not enough people are talking about Dino. So is Dino going to reappear and step in? We're going to see Dino and Murphy. Aberdeen Anarchy, Rodin and Connor may have done a little bit of cheating to win the titles.
Why don't I find that surprising?
A little bit of a low blow, a little bit of a title belt shot to the head, you know, just a little bit of those things. But they're all very confident. But Connor is now referring to himself as the Big Slay. He's now the Big Slay, Connor Mulhigh.
Okay.
And Rodin.
Yeah.
So they put out a big promo on Instagram talking about all these teams that they want to face for the titles, and there were some that I really want to see because I haven't seen them wrestle yet, like Casino Brutal and stuff like that, guys that I really want to see wrestle. But the outfit have cashed in their rematch clause, so it was a good match, really good match, Aberdeen Anarchy, like chaotic, a lot of bodies flying everywhere and stuff. So I expect the same again. And we'll just hope that Rodin doesn't...
I kind of feel like I'm out of the loop a little bit because I missed Anarchy.
Mm-hmm.
I don't really feel like I have much of an opinion this time.
Yeah.
Like, I'm more thinking about how Jack's going to be. I am excited, don't get me wrong.
Oh, you're a bit apprehensive.
I'm quite anxious and wondering how this is going to go.
It could be a smash cut to us in a car going, we didn't see any of it.
Yeah. Just because of the timings of things. I wish that they would do an afternoon show.
One of the main ones, because Galas is different. Galas is, there's no story in Galas.
Yeah.
But
no crying in baseball either.
One you know quite a bit of the story about is the six-man tag. So it's the Foundation of the Future taking on Scotty Swift, Damien, and Omar Muhammad. So at Aberdeen Anarchy, the Foundation won against Damien, Scotty, and William Sterling. Richard R. Russell broke everyone's collective heart by facilitating the beatdown of William Sterling, which had the Foundation win. And Richard Arsenal's supposed to be buying a ticket himself. He'll be there, he'll be at the show, and it's just going to be chaos. Omar's got a little bit of revenge in mind for Mr. WrestleZone getting attacked at Christmas Chaos last year. Damien's still got history left with the Foundation. Scotty, of course, is still...
So that's just going to be a brawl.
Oh yeah, that's going to be the one that covers Dame's Community Centre and just goes all over the place. So last time it was... But this time it hasn't got any like rules. It hasn't got like a stipulation to it. It's just a straight up six man tag, whereas the one at Anarchy was like no holds barred, no disqualification, stuff like that. So weapons was used, tables was used, and all that kind of stuff. So I could see this maybe starting as a match, get a bit chaotic, Mr. P coming out going embrace the chaos, no disqualification, and it just goes absolutely everywhere.
Yeah.
You know, I think that's kind of what that's going to be the play
the
of the day.
The rules are, there are no rules.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah, that kind of thing.
An embrace the chaos match, and it'll just go everywhere, and it'll just escalate probably until chaos again. But I see this one ending in like a steel cage match at some point, you know, just to kind of contain them all.
Yeah.
Kind of thing. But that's going to be absolutely well. For full previews, I do have the WrestleZone podcast where I spent like way too long speaking about all these matches. So
yeah, because I don't know enough about it.
You're better in the loop with it.
And I am really, I do really feel like I'm out of the loop. There's been a lot of personal things going on.
So, and then the last match we've got is Mickey Vago is going after the Undisputed WrestleZone Championship against Caleb Valhalla. Of course, Vago is a favourite on this podcast. We constantly pick him to lose, I think.
Well, I'm definitely picking him to lose against Caleb. Sorry, Mickey Vago. But that's just the way the cookie crumbles, I'm afraid.
So, first defence for Caleb. He's relinquished the Tri-Counties title. The intrigue thing I had for the preview was on commentary through the night will be Aspen. He'll be on the commentary desk. So, will he get involved?
So, he's going to come out from behind the behind that desk at some point.
Yeah. Will he get involved in this match? Will he get involved in the foundation match? I don't know. That could be interesting for future things. Yeah. But will he get involved? Will he assist Caleb as part of Skull Brawl, Discovery Tag Team Champions? Or will he cause some shenanigans and miscommunication?
I don't think you'll find out until we're there.
Yeah.
You know, like, it's going to be one of those things. I think it's going to be decided while you're sitting there.
Mm. So I think that's obviously we're picking Caleb. Sorry, Vago. Any other show? Probably would have given you the credit, but you're against Caleb, so you know. He knows.
Okay.
He knows the deal. And if he wins, he'll lord over me forever. That's how it works. That's our relationship. Mm-hmm. Is him saying I'm wrong and laughing at me. But no, should be good. Christ, 25 minutes we've spent talking about this. So we are nowhere near Aberdeen at the moment, but we'll get there shortly. Next thing will be the montage. Anything you want to add before we go to the montage? Are you quite... We're excited, we're scared. That's pretty much it, isn't it?
Pretty much.
We're excited but scared because, yeah, Jack is very quiet. He's asleep right now, for those that are unaware. They've gotten this far, forgotten I said that at the start. But it's episode 300 of the podcast. How have we got here? I do not know. We've had amazing guests like Grado, like Scotty Tuhati, like Joe Hendry, like Big Demo, like Mike Mondo.
Like Caleb.
Caleb's been on a couple of times. Scotty's been on. Ian Skinner. We've go back to the back catalogue if you haven't. We've got loads of road trips. You're in most of them.
I am in a lot of them because I am the driver.
You're the driver.
I'm
here. Yes. Call me Miss Daisy because I like getting driven to shows.
Meanwhile, you just drive me to destruction.
Snap. So that's it. Yeah, we'll go into the montage next. I've been liking doing them on iMovie at the moment. I just throw them through iMovie and it does it for me. It's great.
Isn't that wonderful?
It saves me half a day of doing it. And then it'll be our thoughts afterwards, which could be the most coherent, excited talk. You might get some comments from the back. Probably won't. If not, it'll be us going, yeah, we saw three matches and then had to go home. Could be that. But that's the mystery of the podcast when it comes to the road trips. So, thank you for those that have listened to the last 299 episodes, or one of them is fine. All of them is even better.
We'll be here without them.
We'll see you in the second half. Right, bye.
Bye.
that was episode 300, my 100th wrestling show. Jack's first. We made it all the way through.
He did make it all the way through.
Did he watch any of it? No.
Not really.
He watched Caleb. He loved Caleb. He met Mr. P.
Met Mr. P.
Loved Mr. P.
Yeah, got a free foam finger. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Martin, for the foam finger. What an out of context sentence to say.
I know. But they'll know.
So I didn't see. I got clips of. You saw the montage. I got at least one or two clips of the show. Were they the most exciting action-packed clips? No. But the montage has been made.
We did have our two-year-old with us.
Jack was.
We thought he was ready.
He is not ready. But I'm glad that he got his first show, my 100th show, and it was WrestleZone. I think that all was kind of married up nicely. But we might wait till next year before we try in round two for him.
Yeah.
But he did phenomenal.
We're only just past Blackburn and he's out for the count.
Yeah,
so, you know.
He's got his guitar in hand and he's asleep. But he stayed up the whole show, eating all the food and drinking all of his juice and then some because it was roasting. Absolutely roasting.
It was really uncomfortably warm in there.
I think the Danes, you can't win with that venue. It's like they're Baltic cold.
It's probably the kind of building that it is. It looks like it's maybe hometown nursery.
Mm-hmm.
So it really doesn't surprise me because you know what Jack's nursery is like, and that's an Elgin. It's probably the same age of a building.
So it's either Baltic cold when it's winter, or absolutely blistering heat when it hits 16 degrees outside.
And there's no such thing as aircon in those old buildings either. So.
No. But no. We did end up getting merch. We got the foam finger, but that was not all. He has a Kayla Valhalla t-shirt now, which he wore.
He's got a lot of growing into it, so you better stay champion for a while, mate.
What was it, 5 to 6 was the size for it?
I think so.
Coincidentally enough, there was a child-sized t-shirt, a Kayla Valhalla t-shirt on sale.
I wonder if that was planned.
I think it was the last one.
Was it? How convenient.
But no.
He was loving Chanting Skull, though.
I loved it. Yeah, we didn't get a video of it. Because we were trying to wrestle a two-year-old, but he was doing he was getting a skull. He liked to cheat in. Well, it was funny when he's watching Bluey, and then there was a big cheer. He would just go yay while he was watching.
Yeah.
So he was engaged. He just wasn't watching it. Of the show itself, from what I saw, I probably won't do a write-up because I didn't see enough of it to really do that. I got all my predictions wrong for I only got one right. Of the Tri-Counties. So the VIP show was Judas Grey against Tommy Raiden. Tommy Raiden won. I didn't get anything thrown at me at the entrance. At the entrance.
Not at the entrance.
Did I use Jack as a shield?
Yes, you did.
I disagree because he's very much a dad's boy today. So he wanted to be. He wanted to shield me.
He wanted to shield me. No, he didn't.
And so I didn't get anything thrown at me. Unfortunately, after Judas lost,
he blamed me. I think it's a lucky charm now, you know? It's maybe a ritual.
He throws something at me at the start.
And then he wins his match.
I don't think he's won a match yet in WrestleZone, but still.
Oh, right, okay then. So it's not your fault then.
It's not my fault.
Because he's definitely throwing stuff at you at WrestleZone.
Yeah. He threw something at me at Disco and won. So, you know, maybe it just needs to be in Edinburgh. I did get someone thrown at me very close by while Jack was sitting on his chair eating whatever he was eating at that point.
Haribo,
something like that.
Plying him with stuff to keep him awake.
While watching Magic Xylophone, Bluey episode. So I had that, and then it was the first match, which...
If you know, you know.
Which was...
First match was...
Ollie? I think it was Ollie and Reese. I think it was Ollie and Reese. So Ollie won that one.
Was it
was a tag title match.
It was
a tag title match. You're right. You're absolutely right. So it was Dino and wasn't. Oh, spoiling it already. It was Ted and Murphy against Flippy and Drippy. Before the bell even rang, Flippy and Drippy attacked the outfit. And they injured Ted, they draped his arm.
But you've forgotten to speak about what happened in the between the VIP match.
Oh, so I have. I wasn't there for. I caught the tail end of it.
You've got footage.
I've got footage. So during the interim between the VIP and the main show, Richard R. Russell arrived.
Came in and took a seat.
Damien came out.
And tried to start on him. And then Scott came out.
And Omar came out and dragged him back.
Mr. P was saying, well, there's nothing we can do. He's a paying customer. It's a lawsuit waiting to happen. Scott, you know, blah, blah, blah. Damien was not to be deterred for a start. You know, he slipped under an arm. Well, he's short. And I can say that because I am short.
He was wily.
He was wily and slipped and went round the other side to try and get to Mr. Russell, and then they talked sense into him and they eventually got him to leave. But yeah, he was quite determined to get to Mr. Russell.
So I wasn't being dense like it when I missed Ronan King swearing. I was changing the boy from jeans into shorts because it was roasting. As I mentioned. So I wasn't like clashed
close. The minute you left the room, Richard R. Russell walked in, and I was like, for God's sake, something's gonna happen here.
So Ted got attacked. He got his arm draped around the ring post, and it was kicked. So he got taken to the back.
When he's got a bad shoulder already.
And so it started with Murphy just taking on the flipping and dripping in a handicap match. Eventually Murphy got the upper hand, and then had his, tried to reach out to the corner. Nobody was there. The outfit music hit and Dino came out to have massive reaction. Good reaction for Dino. Everyone was like, yes! And I think I've been manifesting this return for about, I don't know, how long has Dino been injured? Christmas chaos last year.
6 months.
So every time that I've went, oh, the outfitter in action, is Dino going to be in this match? He came back, demolished people, picked up the win, new tag team champions outfit, Flippy and Drippy's reign only lasting 3 months, something like that. Very quick reign for Flippy and Drippy, even though, this is the first time you've properly seen the big slay, Conor Malloy. Thoughts?
I like his fluffy glasses.
was he a vibe? Glasses. We're both too old for this kind of pattern for vibe. Eh?
I gotta be honest. Because we had Jack there, I wasn't really paying as much attention as I would normally, and I'm really sorry because it deserved more attention.
Yeah,
but. We had our toddler with us. He made a mistake.
He wanted to march and march.
He wanted to march round the ring. I think he was trying to copy entrances.
Oh, yeah. He was having a whale of a time.
He was having a great time, but it wasn't conducive to actually stopping and watching what was going on.
This will be me telling the results, but it won't be a lot of us going, oh, this happened. Because we don't really know. I can tell you for one thing, that was probably the most stressful wrestling show I've ever been to, but I bloody loved it because I got to go with him.
Your face was a picture.
I'm not going to remember a lot of what happened on the show.
But I'll remember that
I took him to that show, and that's the most important thing to me.
So then it was
Ollie versus Rhys Dawkins. Ollie picked up the win then, which was a bit of a surprise. I thought Reese might pick up the win for that one. So we're kind of rattling through this back end here. I might have more thoughts when I do the in-studio bit.
And then it was
Alex. Alex.
Alex.
Yeah.
Alan won that one again.
Surprise. I thought Alex might have picked that. No, what was the problem? He didn't come out to Hero. By Chad Kroger and Josie Scott.
You keep trying to egg this omelette, but it's done, Billy.
No,
he's not Spider-Man.
Hey, He spent his whole match
defending the fact that he wasn't a Spider-Man, you're just going on and reinforcing it.
That's exactly what Spider-Man
he's
would say.
He's not Peter Parker.
That's exactly what Spider-Man would say. So that was Captain Allen's beef. He was determined that Alex Webb was Spider-Man. Captain Allen won again. I was not doing very well with my predictions of who was going to win these matches, as always. But then there was the interval, and then some. This kind of thing started happening where wrestlers were politely saying hello to you, and then kind of brushing me off.
Yeah,
I don't know what was happening because Judas did it.
Yeah, I got a handshake from Judas.
Saying my man. And then
it's probably him thanking me for interrupting your podcast.
And then Alex did the same. I opened the door after going to the toilet, and he was looking all smiling, speaking to yous. Oh, and then went, "Oh, hi, Billy." And
everybody loves me. I keep telling you this.
Everyone loves Kelly. Yeah. Everyone tolerates me, and I think I'm okay with that. I might have a wee cry later, but I think I'm okay. No, I'm generally I'm alright with that.
Cry in your pillow, you'll be fine.
I'll cry in my WrestleZone pillow.
Yeah.
And that's the street light's gone, as you can tell by the episode, but we're still going to continue because there's still some sunlight, but there's trees, so you know. So the interval, met Mr. P. Mr. P was amazing.
He was really nice to Jack.
Jack was loving it. He
buzzing.
Was getting high fives.
We might post a video in the montage.
Did you get a video of that?
Not a video, a picture, sorry.
Picture, yeah. His face is a picture. He was loving it.
He was just, delighted.
Mr. P's cool, though, isn't
he? Yeah, he is.
He's just cool. Second half started with the six-man tag, which
was
chaos.
The foundation and...
Scotty.
Omar, Scotty, and
Damien. Yeah. So that was wild to start off with, and then it kind of settled in the ring a little bit. They got wild again, and when everyone was brawling outside the venue and going around the venue, Omar was in the ring with Zach, and then Richard R. Russell, the absolute bastard, hit Omar with his cane, which was given to him by Mr. P at the before the show started. Saying that he left this at Aberdeen Anarchy, you can have it back, we don't want it. So, you know...
Well, that was idiotic, wasn't it?
I'm saying Omar's going to blame Richard R. Russell, but I'm saying Mr. P might have to...
Facilitated.
Might have to maybe explain... may have to calm down Omar from this, from the situation.
Well, if he was my boss, I'd be asking questions too.
So, you missed a little bit at the end, because Jack needed changed. So, what happened was Richard R. Russell... kind of told Zach to pin Omar, so they got the win, and then he shook hands with the foundation. It looks like they're now a quartet, Richard R. Russell leading the foundation in the future, but they're not going to be the foundation in the future in WrestleZone. They're going to be the Sterling Oil Killers.
Oh, we've got Sterling Oil back.
Well, right. No, because the foundation killed them. So that seems to be where that is aimed, whether that is just with Zach talking and they're still going to be the foundation of the future, but really they're here and now, so I think the foundation of the future name is kind of a bit redundant, a little bit. It could be the foundation, you know. So it looks like they're going to be the Sterling Oil Killers for a little bit, the sock. Sterling Oil Killers, the sock.
Okay.
I might have just ruined it for them, and that they'll just be the foundation going forward.
Okay. The sock. You're making an anagram. I was confused. It's fine.
Acronym.
I don't care.
I don't know. It's half past nine. It's been a long day.
I'm hardly sleeping by now.
It's been a long day. Then pre main event was it was Brian Tucker against Evan Young.
Yeah.
Which Brian Tucker won. Again, surprise. that was the only one I got right. So the only one out of the four I got right was Brian Tucker winning, because I wanted Brian and Reese in the semis. So at the moment it's going to be Tommy Raiden against Captain Allen in the semis, and Oliver Green versus Brian Tucker, which is none of the matches I predicted. So I'm going to go for, out of those, I'm going to go for Ollie just now, for now. It's my early prediction.
Ollie and Wally.
Holly and Wally.
Sorry.
So that's my early prediction. But Brian Tucker's been around WrestleZone for a long time. I, as a sentimental win, him winning it would have him be a Triple Crown winner, or a Grand Slam winner. So that would be quite cool to be the second person to be able to do all that. So that would be quite nice. But I'm going to go Ollie for the meantime. So I may have just may put a nail in your title hopes and dreams there, Ollie. I apologise. And then the main event was the only match that Jack paid attention to for minutes at a time, which was Gil Valhalla versus Mickey Vago, which was, from bits I saw, hard hitting.
Yeah.
Very hard hitting, just two lads just smacking the shit out of each other for a bit.
Two guys who are really good at it,
yeah. Yeah, just... we got tops off Vago.
I didn't notice.
No, I was because you were paying too much attention to Caleb, and I heard you just go, "Oh!" Because Vago had taken off his vest.
Oops.
So I think Vago will take that as a compliment. If you go back and watch the footage, and there's a, oh, that's Kelly just noticing that you took your shirt off.
Oh,
you know
God.
What? He was in good shape.
You probably will hear me, because apparently I feature on a lot of the news.
He was in good shape. He's doing the work.
Yeah.
That was the running kind of comment we had when we saw Vago back at the first show back. Looking good, doing the work. Tremendous and all that. So hard hitting. Caleb eventually won with a great, I think it was a suplex off the top rope, and then he kind of rolled through and lifted Vago up for a jackhammer to get the win, which was very impressive.
Jackhammer.
Hey, there you go, Caleb. Hey. Caleb, you left a t-shirt. You left a conveniently small t-shirt for sale, and you finished the match with a jackhammer. We love you, Caleb.
We do.
That's probably an absolute coincidence for the second one, but we love you anyway. Yes, and I finally got a conspiracy theory, like, ticked off, because Regal Rumble, remember we went to Regal Rumble, and Caleb won, and then weirdly enough, it started the countdown again.
Yeah.
Right? It happened again at Aberdeen Anarchy as well.
Yeah.
And I thought, like, once is a tech issue, twice is suspicious.
Three times a
Monstrum's here. Monstrum is in WrestleZone. Monstrum looked terrifying. Mainly because last time we saw him, he was far away.
Yeah.
At disco.
He was really close this time.
He was really close. And you got to see that mask, like the kind of, like skin mask kind of thing he's got going on.
It's
so,
almost horror-esque. Oh. That's going to be a really good match at Hijinks, I think.
Yeah, I think it's going to be, I could put a Halloween brawl in there. Get the weapons going.
Yeah.
So, Monstrum arrived. There's a big scary video package, which actually I got a little bit scared watching it. You know?
Yeah.
I mean, I don't like horror films anyway. I get scared.
You're more scared than your child.
He had a wee cry, but he was tired. But if Monstrum wants to take that as making kids cry, then he can take it. I'm not going to argue with him. It's terrifying. So, he.
Is that something to be proud of, Monstrum?
He battered Caleb. Aspen, who was on commentary the night, he ran out, and that was the other one that seemed to be, it was very friendly speaking to you, and then was just like, yeah. So he came out, and then he got beaten up by Monstrum. They got choke slammed. Oh, vicious choke slams. They were just big choke slams. So Monstrum is a guy
I didn't really pay much attention. I had somebody jibbering in my
log. But Monstrum. Sorry. Monstrum is a guy we've seen who's very familiar to Skull Brawl, so we'll see how that plays out.
He's in disco, isn't he?
He's in disco, yeah. He's part of the Good Times with Rob Stowe, so we saw them. That's who we saw.
He doesn't look like he gives
anybody
a good time.
He has a good time. Killing people. But that was a scary end. We were going to try and hang about to see Caleb.
My prediction is that in WrestleZone, because they already are a tag team in disco.
Yeah, they've had one match as a team in WrestleZone.
In WrestleZone, I think that they're going to team up and it might be a triple threat match.
Oh.
Try and beat this Monstrum.
I think Aspen might try and put in his rematch clause for Hijinks and then we get a triple threat.
Yeah, I think that they might turn into a tag team in WrestleZone.
Yeah, I think we're going to see more Skull Brawl, definitely.
Which is good because we like them both.
We like them,
and then we can cheer them both.
Yeah.
You know, for about nearly three years, we've been against one another. This time, we can be on the same team.
There we go. So yeah, so it's all a little bit, a Skull Brawl and WrestleZone at the start of the year, but we're definitely, I think, yeah, we're definitely getting them more properly.
It's only in May.
No, no, but the Grand City Showdown in January, they teamed up against Flippy and Drippy.
Oh, okay, I missed that.
Yeah, so
they,
like I said, we kind of shown their friendship.
I thought you were talking about when we went to Edinburgh.
Ah, that was right, yeah. Aye.
Never mind.
So we'll definitely see more Skull Brawl. I like that prediction of a triple threat at Hijinks. Aspen putting in his rematch clause for the title, and then Monstrum's there. Kind of like, yeah, I like that. It won't happen, but I like that. You never know. Mr. P listen, hopefully listens. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm really tired. I was good for winking, but my eyes just went, nah. If you close that eye, you're going to sleep.
Please don't.
No. We'll be chatting at length off camera and all that kind of stuff. I didn't see as much of the wrestling as I would see any other time. You didn't see as much wrestling as would any other time, but I had an absolute, this is a very sentimental show for me, not only because it was my 100th, but because it was his first.
You still
don't have your stats. I will have that for the next second, and I'm sitting in my office by myself.
Okay.
I will have those stats, and then I'm probably going to look at the shows I've been to and go, oh shit, was Kelly at that one as well? Oh no. I will find out though. I will have those stats.
We know where to start from.
Oh shit, do it. I thought it was Rockin' Wrestling. Yeah. Cool. Yeah, we know where to start from. And then we'll hope for the best from there. But a great, fantastic night. WrestleZone always put on good hospitality. They provide a great atmosphere.
That was a good
for a
family show.
Good family show. And next one, his one will probably be next year now, because we've tried it. It's not quite ready for it.
It's not ready.
But we've done it.
We've done it.
So thank you, WrestleZone. We'll sit on to the next bit. He's staring.
Yeah, he's staring. I think we should wrap this up.
Now. We're gonna go right back to the studio, Billy.
Several days later.
So here we are back in the studio. This has been recorded a couple of days after doing the recap, where we had Wednesday the 14th, and the recap I did on Monday when that thing decided to try and kill me. It was nowhere near me, it's fine. But yeah, that was a bit of a scary moment with the photo frame falling down. But here I am, episode 300. I did the stats, I tried to do the stats, and by my reckoning, and I'm hoping I'm wrong, I'm hoping that I'm missing two somewhere, and I think I may have at least one. But Kelly's stats, so mine is 100 wrestling shows that I've been to, 100, including WWE, Discovery, SWE, WrestleZone, Rock and Wrestle, all of that kind of stuff, W3L. I hit 100 with Battle of the Nations. Jack hit 1 as he was at Battle of the Nations this past Saturday. And Kelly, by my reckoning, hit 23, which when I gave her that number, was way more than she thought. So she hit at least 23. I'm hoping I've missed two and she's hit 25. That'd be cool if that was like kind of the nice round number, zeros and fives, you know, that'd be quite a cool milestone to hit a quarter of a century of shows. But that was wild. It was wild. I am so tired. It's Wednesday. So what have we done? We did, we're up late a bit on the Friday, and just because we're friends over and whatnot. Saturday we did Battle of the Nations, but that included also going to Cadona's and having a very fun day doing slotting in 2P machines and what have you. Sunday was Mac Murray, so we went to the Cooper Park here in Elgin to watch the likes of Status Quo, and Bonnie Tyler absolutely just, oh, that was rough. But Cascada and The Feeling were ace, so you know, all made up. Torridon were fantastic as well. They're from Inverness. I saw them at the Easter Mac Murray event, and they were fantastic. And they were the first act on, so I insisted that we had to be there for doors open so I could go see Torridon. Listen to Torridon from the seated area with my little camping chair and my bucket hat. Sorry, Patrick. I'm taking bucket hats now. That's just the way it is. So yeah, it's been busy. Monday was kind of recovering from that. I went back to work, so I mean, this is where I work anyway. I work in this room, so that wasn't a huge commute, but trying to concentrate on anything was very difficult. Then we had a chat with Ryan Richards on the Monday, which was for episode 301, which will be the next episode that comes out probably Monday, I think it is, on this timeline of going out. In the interim of all that, we had the episode with the Big Strong Man go out, which Tom Campbell was a part of. He was fantastic. Just to peel back the curtain on that, I messaged him like the day before the interview and went, "Listen, mate, I've got this very cheeky axe, but I've got the Big Strong Man on. Do you want to send a message to him?" And within hours, he was like, "Yeah, I could do that." And the next morning, I had a video, and that's the one you see in the episode with the Big Strong Man. He's just Tom Campbell. Is fantastic. He's a guy that I've admired from afar. So I don't know if he's thinking, Christ, this guy's messaging me quite a lot, tagging me and things quite a lot. But he's been a guy that I've really enjoyed listening to through Cultaholic. I was introduced through Cultaholic really through Matthew, and then through Matthew, I now know the voice of Tom Campbell. And I've emailed him a couple of times for advice on interviews, like the one I did with Moose as part of the TNA build up for, I think it was Slammiversary or the UK tour. It was for the UK tour. So I emailed him and asked for a little bit of advice how to pack in as much as I can in 15, 20 minutes. And he came back to me that same day and went, "Look, keep it with your niche and all that kind of stuff." He's just an absolutely delightful human. I don't want to make the back half of this podcast all about Tom Campbell, but I will. No, he was just fantastic. Not enough good thing words to say about Tom Campbell. And I'm excited to see all these opportunities that he's receiving through North, through Discovery, through WOS, and Impact Wrestling and TNA and all that kind of good stuff. He seems like my brief interactions and my listenings to him through Cultaholic, he's just just a beautiful human. Sorry about that. It wouldn't be an episode 300 without me absolutely spluttering coughing everywhere. But what a night. Battle of the Nations. I love the show. I as much as I saw of it. The stuff's coming back to me. You know, I might still do. I probably won't do a write-up because I don't think I'll do the shows justice. I won't do the matches justice. But for what I'm remembering, I'm remembering a lot more of the matches than I think I remember. Like a lot of it must have been taken in somewhere. I definitely saw like all the main event. I saw Caleb most like 99% of Caleb versus Vago, and I saw Monstrum appear as well, which was scary. Monstrum is a scary dude. I think it's the mask. You know, I've seen previous iterations of the Monstrum mask, and it's been kind of like a balaclava with the mask over the top. But this one's got like the back piece to it. It looks like it's like scalped skin. It's terrifying. I'm looking forward to seeing where that goes. Looking at my upcoming wrestlingness, I don't know really where my next show is going to be. I've like earmarked Inverurie, and I've also earmarked Ardler Mania down in Dundee for Fair City Wrestling, and it may just end up being one or the other depending on how just how things go, because I'm in Berwick at the start of September for a family holiday, and we come back on the Friday, and Inverurie show is on the Saturday. So I think that one might have to be missed, but I'm going to try to do a preview show anyway on the Sunday and get that out and prepared. So it won't be the most complete WrestleZone podcast, but it'll be a podcast regardless. I'll talk about the show because Inverurie. Get a decent show out of Inverurie. It's every time I've been, I think I've been to the last two in Inverurie at the Hopeville Social Club, and they put on cracking shows. It is an absolute roasting venue, though. So if you thought Dainston was hot, God help you for Inverurie. Last two times I've been there, it was September's ish, September, October's ish, and they've been absolutely boiling venues. So go prepare accordingly. No, take a fan if you have to, and not your friend, but take a physical fan, like one of those little, like one of these kind of bad boys. Take one of these and, hydrate. Just do whatever you can because they're hot venues. But I won't talk, I won't yabble on too long because I know that I've already hit an hour between me and Kelly just absolutely rambling nonsense for between going to and from the show. But I had a fantastic time. It wasn't one of those shows where I had a fantastic time because I saw an amazing match. And that's only because I had an amazing time for a sentimental value, which was I got to take my son to his first wrestling show. And that was incredible to me. I don't know whether my dad had the same thought, because he wasn't a big wrestling fan. But back in 2001, he took me to my first wrestling show at Elgin Town Hall. It was a tribute show. I don't remember an awful lot about it, but and I was 11, but 10, it was 10. But one of those moments where I just, yeah, can't forget. And there's the doorbell. So I'm going to be back in 2 seconds.
A few moments later.
Wouldn't be an SWN podcast with some sort of weird something happening. But no, just before I go, before I round up, I've had an absolute blast doing 300 episodes of this podcast between road trip episodes, interviews, and what I've been able to cobble together through this last 4 years. I've enjoyed it. I've really enjoyed it. I've enjoyed every second of it. Even when doing things like organizing the bonanzas or just getting panicky when I'm trying to do an interview with the likes of like Scotty Tuhati or Mike Mondo, or like trying to figure out time differences as well. I've enjoyed it. I'm so unfit. I'm just breathless running up and down stairs. But no, I've had an absolute blast doing this podcast, and it's going to continue. We've got plans for episodes, well, right up until the end of September-ish. And we're going to just keep going. We're going to end the season. Plan is December. I think that's the plan anyway, but we'll see what happens. We've got Christmas chaos in the horizon. Hopefully that'll be good too for that. Start of December. And we'll see what we can do, see what we can cobble together. So this initially was supposed to go, this season anyway, was supposed to go from, like, when did I start? March to July, and I'm still going, and this will be coming up to September episodes with lots of different kinds of guests, different guests from all kind of experiences, not just in Scottish wrestling, but even if they've just had a dalliance to Scottish wrestling, I want to get them on and have a quick chat. I'd keep it an hour or so. Some don't hit that hour, but it's fine because we just have a natural conversation and that's how it ends. But in the meantime, this has been Billy. Thank you for watching, listening to the SWN podcast. Thank you for supporting Scottish Wrestling Network. Just thank you. I can't believe that we're still going. 300 episodes in. We've got lots more people that want to get on and lots more emails that I will be sending, lots more DMs I will be tapping as well. But in the meantime, please follow us on all the social medias at ScottResNet on Instagram, Twitter/X, and Facebook. And follow us on Spotify, follow us on Apple Podcasts, rate, review, subscribe, 5 stars, please. And subscribe to us to YouTube. YouTube is one I really want to get to that 1,000 subscriber mark and really try and open up what more we can do with my very limited knowledge of funds. But I'm going to try and do all we can. Patreon.com as well, patreon.com/ScottResNet. Check us out there and check out the descriptions below in the video for the cool stuff we have through the likes of Render Bomb, Manscaped, and Hot Tag Foundation. This has been an absolute joy to do, and I will continue to do so. So for now, we're gonna close off episode 300 by me awkwardly looking to try and hit the stop record button. But in the meantime, thank you for listening, thank you for watching, thank you for supporting. My name's been Billy. This has been episode 300 of SWN Podcast. See you next time.